I have tweak in my pool. What am I going to do about this? Some people would even lose steam in the round to get to it.
Yeah, like new game, new nerves too. And some of the top players from beforehand, even PGR top 100 players, like it's now your reputation on the line. It's who's watching that, you know, yeah, I won this stuff before. I won 2GC championships. I won like the last Evo. I won all this. But like now it's like, that doesn't matter. Like, what are you doing today?
So absolutely.
That's what we'll be seeing at Genesis all weekend. Again, the first S tier for Smash Ultimate PGRU season starting with a bang. Over 2,000 entrants setting records for the highest, like, entrant-based grassroots event ever to be put on.
Right, and that excludes Evo as
yeah, because that's
grassroots,
not grassroots.
Right.
I mean, it's, yeah, you know, put on by, like, a really, you know, coordinated and successful, like, team, like the Evo team, similar to, like, CEO, which is Bailey. That is, like, an FGC, like, you know, mecha event. This
right.
is a four Smashers by Smashers. So props to the Genesis team and also to whoever wins the whole thing, because that's gonna set you up basically for the rest of the season.
Yeah, and for like the history of the game too. Like, you're never gonna forget who won the first Genesis, right?
Yeah, we'll never forget that first Apex 2015 top 8, where we had things like MVD's Duck Hunt, where we had things like Abadango's Pac-Man,
like 6WX coming out of nowhere.
Oh my gosh, 6WX, yeah.
Yeah, and the start, of course, of Zero's Legacy.
But anyway,
guys, we're gonna kick it off right into our next match with one of the best tags I've ever seen, which is Your Naked Grandma.
Oh my god!
And he's going to be taking on Wadi. I believe Your Naked Grandma played Mewtwo and or Bowser Jr. It was one of those two in Smash 4,
so
SoCal player.
I'm gonna pause, and I'm just going to call the player against Wadi playing. Do you want to call him Naked or Grandma?
Grandma.
Okay, Grandma. I like Grandma, because Your Naked Grandma played Greninja is
weird. Oh, did she? I didn't even know.
Anyways, Wadi, 19 seed this tournament. A lot of hype coming out of MDVA. Wadi not sporting Mewtwo, but instead Rob, another character that he definitely wrecked with many a gyro setup in Smash 4. He's sporting him again. And apparently Rob's even better this time, because all the burying that you see right now and like his aerial like game, it's devastating still. And like new things kill that didn't used to.
Yeah, the Z-drop gyro into side B, man. That's pretty much all you need to know about this character.
And this new side B, like, it is just overwhelming. And he takes the first stock with that. And Wadi, you know, like, just really over the top right now. And it is showing no signs of slowing down, actually.
Yeah, this guy's been pretty much dominating within his region. Him and ZD running house at Xanadu. And, of course, a seventh place finish at Glitch 6. Very solid. And Wadi actually not a frequent attender of many events outside of his region yet in Ultimate. So
yeah, keeping it quiet. I mean, all the boys are cooking, you know, within their regions, but like now that there's these events that you have to prove yourself, like you can't just say, oh, I'm taking all my region's money. It's like you need to take now everyone's money. You need to get those Ws. You need to get those first place finishes at S tier and A tier. Now that the season started, like you have to travel. And we see Wadi out here, you know, making a name for himself again.
Grandma keeping it close though, 75, he gets a KO pretty soon, he's in a good spot. Oh, that ledge roll just going to sneak right on by, one of the few things that allows you to bypass that body blocking that prevents cross-ups. Rolls, and particularly the ledge roll, I feel like it's very effective at doing that.
Yeah, so it's always frustrating seeing Rob getting back, because he's out of reach, he's coming down with things that auto-cancel, and also disjointed, and projectiles. Like, we're going to have to see Grandma really, you know, change up how he's really looking out for those landings, because the thing with Rob is falling with Nair, it's frustrating and it can be tilting because you can't catch him. And so whether or not he makes those changes, like we're gonna see how he changes the computer set.
Oh, and that anti-air laser just stuffing out the jump. You see Wadi very comfortably even in the corner. Oh, and that interrupt Shadow Sneak. Yeah, you have a hurt box before you have a hitbox coming out of that move.
Yeah, clean up smash by Wadi. We're now sitting at 2 stocks and 1 stock apiece. Doesn't seem like he's facing any real troubles here. Grandma has a little bit to kind of learn with gyro, but at the same time, everybody gets hit by that. You know, it's something that can be so frustrating because you want to try and grab it, but it has a hitbox. The spinning top's frustrating for sure.
Yo, Wadi's combo right there, man. Just carrying him from center stage all the way to the left edge. That was gorgeous. Now he's got the gyro in hand. Yeah, we're going to see a lot of Z-drop aerials to keep the pressure on. Sometimes even extend the combos if the Z-drop actually connects before he picks it back up.
Yeah, we're seeing some steam from Grandma, just like we saw in the last Smash iteration. Falling with Nair, then comboing with a dragging up air. Like, we're seeing it, but then, of course, Wadi's interrupting with his Nair's and his own, but that berry into up smash is so devastating.
Yeah, you gotta sacrifice your controller to the gods to get out of that sometimes.
Yeah, why is that allowed?
I don't know, man. I've never made a game, so I'm not in a position to comment.
Yeah, so some of the controversy in the beginning of this game centering around certain mechanics now with Barry, with Inkling Roller, of course, K. Rool, and now Rob, leaves a lot of players kind of frustrated because they're trying to mash, but also they're not trying to make the wrong input right after. So
exactly.
You're buffering it, you're getting out, you're at ledge, and you're Wolf, for example, then you end up side B. So clean game by Wadi, game one. And taking it to Pokemon Stadium 2 now, we'll see if this change benefits him at all.
Grandma with another chance here. Gets the opening gambit successfully, but there's so much more work to do. You've got three full stocks to peel off your opponent. One of the things that a lot of people say contributes to making this game more consistent than Smash 4 in terms of results. So far, it's really seemed that way. I think that's he double dips! Wadi closing the first stock in 30 seconds.
And we see actually his opponent laughing it off. Obviously, you just have to give it to your opponent sometimes when the props are owed. I mean, that was bravery, and he didn't challenge it. You know, it was just like, wow. And we're seeing now, like, in this new game, offstage interactions are so meaningful. And just like that, he two frames him with his down air. That hurtbox being massive.
Yeah, it's a lot tougher to recover in this game. There's very little forgiveness on a lot of recoveries. Two framing doesn't give you your jump back.
Yeah, I mean, definitely, like, you really can't afford to be two frame. And planning your recovery now, I mean, especially like characters against, like against Rob, it's just, if you make that mistake, that could be the stock. And here we see it.
That is a three stock.
That is bizarre.